Okay, after that Dunkley by-election result, let's go to Victoria and catch up with Keith Wolahan, who's the Liberal member for the seat of Menzies in Melbourne. Good to talk to you, Keith. You must be disappointed about that outcome, an average swing against the government.
Thank you, Chris. I'm not disappointed. Just under a year ago, I was there on the night when we had a 6.3% two-party preferred swing against us. We've now had an almost 4% two-party preferred swing once the postals have finished counted. That is, when you combine those two together, that is a significant change from where we were a year ago. And that's a credit to Peter Dutton, the team and the coalition for the way we have prosecuted this government, for the incompetent way that they have handled a number of issues. And number one is not addressing the cost of living issues.
Yeah, well, there are those cost of living issues. There's also been the border security shambles and the non-citizen criminals who are out and about in the community, some of them reoffending. So you would have thought you'd go close to winning this seat. You would have pushed Labor to the brink in this seat.
Look, you always hope that you would win. And we had an outstanding candidate in Nathan Conroy. He left nothing off the pitch. He just put everything into it and gave, I think, one of the best concession speeches that I've seen in an election. So Nathan's got a very bright future. But this is a first-term government. And Australians are generous to first-term governments. They give them a chance, but they don't let them have a second chance. And that's what the people of Dunkley and the people of Melbourne and Australia will be asking this government when it comes to the next election. Have you earned the right for a second chance?
Well, let's look at policy differentiation. And you would have heard me just talking about nuclear energy. Labor already digging in against that. I would have thought most people understand this is the future if you want zero emissions electricity that is reliable. Yet the current Prime Minister scoffs at it. Here's Anthony Albanese today.
There's a debate. Every 10 years, there was at the beginning of the Abbott government, guess what? Nothing happened. There was during the Howard government, guess what? Nothing happened. And no one has ever been prepared to put up a dollar. And the market shows that renewables is the cheapest form of energy.
So something will happen this time, Keith?
Well, you can hear the arrogance in the way that was put. Of course, people haven't put up a dollar when there's a ban. Labor need to explain what just about every other first world country is doing wrong in relying upon cheap nuclear power. It's there. We're an outlier when it comes to COP. And then when you look at Australia, we are an island continent. We have stable continent to put nuclear small modular reactors that aren't vulnerable to earthquakes like other nations are. And we have the natural resources here. If you were to pick a country on earth, Australia is the most appropriate. And I think one day a future Labor Party will be on board, but it just doesn't make sense, the position that they're adopting now.
Yeah, we ought to pick up that South Australian idea too for a global nuclear waste repository. We could make billions of dollars every year out of that. Now, I just want to mention something about your colleague Zoe McKenzie. She was on this program last week prior to the Dunkley by-election. Here's what she had to say.
Nathan Conroy has done everything right. The sense of warmth and engagement and familiarity and trust with him, between him and his constituents as the Mayor of Frankston, has been fantastic. In that candidate, Nathan Conroy, they've got somebody who's ready on day one.
Yeah, well, there you go. Unsurprisingly, wholehearted support for the Liberal candidate. She was very critical of Labor, of course, as well, campaigning strongly. Yet on Saturday night, she put out this tweet showing a photo of herself with the winning Labor candidate, who she knows very well, their neighbouring electorates. She says, congratulations to Jodie Bellayer. You've been a good friend to women across the Mornington Peninsula. Look forward to working with you in looking after paradise. Apparently, Keith, a lot of your Liberal colleagues in Victoria are in meltdown over this. I mean, this is what the public square should be like, shouldn't it? You have a good political battle, and when the other side wins, you say, congratulations.
100%. Zoe McKenzie is a formidable advocate and a decent person, and she did the right thing by fighting the good fight, which she did for Nathan Conroy, and then acknowledging the winner. That's what we do in a democracy. To do otherwise is to disrespect the voters and our democracy. And I think we need more of the kindness and the good grace that was shown by Zoe McKenzie. More power to her arm.